Victoria's Education Minister has denied there's conflicting advice between the federal and state governments regarding face-to-face schooling. James Molino says Victorian parents have taken the advice with 30,000 laptops distributed for at-home learning. Lana Murphy with that story.
With the home bell ringing, this is Elizabeth Baum's first and last trip to school this term.
You enjoy that? We'll see you online.
Like more than a million Victorian children, the grade 5 student will rely on technology to talk to her teachers.
We have this program called Google Classroom, and basically, in my words, it would be like a Facebook for kids.
To assist the 97% of students now learning from home, 30,000 laptops and tablets have been loaned, the bulk of supplies coming from existing school resources, with 500 dongles and SIM cards also rolling out, the government prioritising bushfire-impacted communities and vulnerable students. But this East Gippsland mother says her children are missing out.
They got print out of worksheets enough for 3 weeks. They've only got enough work for 3 weeks.
So you're not getting laptops?
No, we haven't got laptops.
Her 10-year-old daughter lives with ADHD, Asperger's and autism.
I've had to call in sick for the rest of the week because I've had no one to look after the kids.
We don't want a million students, 80,000 teachers, support staff, parents and carers congregating around our schools. This is about social distancing and it is working.
But in its first set of education guidelines handed out today, the federal government says education is best delivered by professional teachers to students in the classroom on school campus. But in Victoria, school grounds will remain largely empty for the entirety of Term 2. Whether remote learning will extend beyond that depends completely on the decision of our Chief Health Officer.
There is no confusion in the messaging from the Victorian government.
Learning is not a place. You can learn anywhere.
Lana Murphy, Nine News.